Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll be covering what is need of source code control, history of source code management, and also I will explain roles and code in DevOps. Guys, I will explain all these three topics in detail. Guys, I have uploaded complete DevOps subject tutorials. I will provide that link in description. You can watch from there. If you are watching this video for the first time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Let's get started. First, I will explain what is need of source code control. But before starting this, you need to know what is source code control. Guys, we also call this source code control as version control. Source code control is a system that helps you to manage and store your files, particularly the code you write. Guys, source code control is nothing but it is a software. In that software, we can store our files and as well as we can manage our files. That is nothing but we can modify our files, we can update our files, we can delete our files and so on. We can perform various operations on that files. So source code control is nothing but it is a software. In that software, we can store our files and as well as we can manage our files. Mainly the source code control is used by developers in order to store their code. Whenever developer write any code, he will store that code in source code control. Later on, he will perform various operations on that code. In DevOps, we will use two kinds of tools for source code control. They are Git and GitHub. Guys, for example, I am a developer. I written code. In DevOps, whenever developer write code, at first he will place that code in Git software. Git is nothing but Git is a software that is present in your system. So whenever developer place that code in Git software, only this developer can access that code. Remaining employees cannot access that code. If all remaining employees want to access this code, then this developer need to send this code to GitHub. So from Git, this developer will send code to GitHub. GitHub is nothing but it is a website. So at first developer will write code and he will send that code to Git. Git is nothing but it is a software that is present in your system. Only this developer can access this code. Remaining employees cannot access this code. So if all remaining employees want to access this code, then you need to place this code from Git to GitHub. GitHub is nothing but it is a cloud-based website. So whenever developer places that code in GitHub, all remaining employees can access that code. And all these employees can perform various operations on that code. This is all about Git and GitHub. Git is a software tool that can be used locally on your computer. You can create a local repository on your computer where you can store and manage your code. Guys, repository is nothing but it is a place where we will store all our files. So in your computer, you can create a local repository and you can store all your files in that repository. GitHub is a web-based platform that allows you to store your Git repositories in the cloud. By writing small lines of commands, you can easily transfer your data from Git to GitHub. Whenever you place your files in GitHub, all remaining employees in your project can access those files. So multiple people can work on the same project, submit changes, review code, and manage projects. They can perform various modifications on your files. Guys, there is an American author. His name is Terence McKenna. He passed one statement. That is, he said that everything is a code. But whether you believe that or not, in DevOps, almost everything is a code. Almost many parts of work can be described, managed, and automated using code. For example, I want to create an application. So for that purpose, I need to write code. So in DevOps, after creating application, you need to set up infrastructure. That is nothing but you need to set up servers and as well as network in order to place our application. So in order to automatically configure our server and network, again you need to write code. In DevOps, we'll use code in order to automatically configure our servers and networks based on our application. So in DevOps, we will not create documents manually. We will also automate documentation process by writing code. And in order to run our application, we need to set up hardware. Even for this, again, we need to use code in order to automate this process. So in order to create application and in order to set up infrastructure, that is nothing but in order to automatically set up servers and networks, we'll write code. In order to create documentation, we will use code. And in order to set up hardware, we'll use code. So whatever Terence McKenna said is correct. In DevOps, almost everything is a code. Next, I will explain why we need source code control. Guys, the source code control acts as central storage. That is nothing but all our code, scripts and documentations. All are kept in one place. So we can easily find and manage those files. Second one is teamwork. whenever you place your code in source code control, all developers can work together on that same code. For example, GitHub is example of source code control. So whenever I write code and place that code in GitHub, all remaining employees can work on that same code. For example, this developer modified my code. So immediately GitHub will store those changes. So immediately GitHub will store who made changes, when they made changes, and what changes they made. So by using source code control, teamwork is possible. Developer can work together on same code. The source code control keeps track of changes made by different people. Third one is tracking changes. I already said before, whenever any developer perform changes, every change is saved. It will store who made changes, when they made changes, and what changes they made. Everything is stored. And if there is any problem, then we can go back to early version of code. Fourth one is backup. The source code control acts as backup. For example, if you consider GitHub website, it is cloud-based website. So even if there is any damage to your system, you can easily restore our data because our data is present in cloud. So even if there is any damage to your system, you can easily restore our data because our data is present in cloud-based website. Fifth one is history. If any developer perform modifications on our code, then we can easily see who made changes, when they made changes, and at what time they made changes, and so on. So we can see who made changes and when they made changes. So this helps us to understand why changes were made and finding bugs. So we can easily find errors. And sixth one is consistency. Guys, meaning of consistency is correctness. Repository is nothing but it is a place where our complete data is stored. As all developers are using only one repository, everything will be correct. Seventh one is deployment. Guys, in DevOps, everything is automated. So whenever developer perform any modifications on code, automatically testing is performed on that code and then that code is placed in server. So in DevOps, this process is automated. So releasing newer versions of software is very easy. So in DevOps, source code control is very important because source code control is a place where we will store our entire project. So in source code control, as complete project is present in one place, all employees can easily access and manage that project. Without source code control, managing our project is very difficult. So good source code control is very important for success in DevOps. Next, I will explain history of source code management. If you understand history of source code management, then you will get to know why it is important today. These are some of the important points. First one is storing older versions of code. Guys, in olden days, if people want to store their older versions of code, then they used to store them in separate files or archives. This method is very simple and useful. For example, I am a developer. I developed code. So I will store this code in separate file. And later on I updated this code. So again I will store this updated version in another file. So again I will update. And again I will store this code in separate file. Like that, people kept older version of their code in separate files. And later on they used a centralized source code management to check in and check out. Guys, centralized source code management is nothing but our complete code is stored in one particular location. So only one employee can access that code at a time. So while one employee is accessing that code, remaining employees cannot access that code. For example, this is centralized source code management tool. Total there are 4 developers. Now this developer want to modify this code. Whenever this developer want to modify this code, then he will log this file. If this developer log this file, remaining employees cannot access this file at the same time. For example, now this developer want to access this file. If this developer want to access this file, then this developer must release that log. Only if this developer release that log, remaining employees can access that file. This is all about centralized source code management. In some systems, a developer could log a file to work on it alone. So no other else could change it at the same time. Each file was managed separately. Guys, there are 2 tools. One is RCS, stands for Revision Control System, and another one is SCCS, stands for Source Code Control System. But nowadays, no one are using this. These are outdated. After that, later on, people used centralized store with merging before committing. Guys, centralized store is nothing but where our complete code is kept in one place. I will give one example. For example, this is centralized store. I am developer. I return code and I will place that code in centralized store. After placing my code, I will perform commit operation. Guys, commit is nothing but saving that code permanently. So once if I perform commit operation, this code is permanently stored in centralized store. For example, now there is another developer. This developer wants to update this code. So he will take this code and he will update that code. So now he will merge this code with existing code. After merging this code, he will perform commit operation. That is nothing but now this code is stored permanently in centralized store. Guys, there are two types of tools. They are concurrent version system and as well as subversion system. If you are using these two types of tools, then you need to merge changes before you commit them. If I update any code, then I need to commit that code. Only if you commit that code, then the changes are permanently stored. Concurrent version system is outdated, but subversion is still used by many of the companies. Now at present, most of them are using decentralized source code management. The name itself says decentralized. That means our complete code is not stored in only single place. I'll give an example. Guys, centralized means our complete code is present in one single location. So if any employee want to work with that code, then he need to work from here itself. And whereas decentralized means developer will not work in the centralized location. What developer will do is, developer will work in his own system. Guys, I will give one simple example of centralized and decentralized. For example, there is a library. If you want to read books, then you will go to library. Similarly, if your friend want to read books, he will go to library. Different people are going to library. So we call this library as centralized. For example, I want to read books. I have my own library in my house. Similarly, my friend want to read books. Then he has his own library in his house. So each person has personal library in his house. So we call it as decentralized. Similarly, if all developers place their code in one single server, then we call it as centralized. Similarly, each developer has full code on their computer and they will perform various operations on that particular code in their system itself and they will communicate each other. We call it as decentralized. Git software is one of the example. Decentralized source code management allows for more flexibility and faster workflow. The most popular tool in this category is Git. Not only Git tool, there are some other tools like Bazaar and Mercurial. Decentralized tools are very powerful, but they can also be risky if you don't use carefully. These are some of the key points. First one is, most popular decentralized tool is Git. And second point is, by using these decentralized tools, people can work better way and collaborate better. And next point is, these decentralized tools are more powerful and flexible. As they are more powerful, if you don't use them properly, then there is high chance for mistakes. In olden days, people used to store their data in files. But at present, people are using decentralized source code management in order to store their files. So by seeing this, you can clearly understand how technology is improving day by day, from storing data in files to storing data in decentralized tools. Next, I will explain roles and code in DevOps. Guys, in DevOps, source code management tools like Git and GitHub are very important because by using these tools, all team members can communicate each other and they can work together smoothly. Guys, in DevOps, there are various kinds of employees use these tools. And the first one is developers. Daily developers will write code. And whatever the code that the developers write, they will store that code in Git. So, developers use source code management every day to do their coding work. And next one is operations team. Before placing our software in server, at first we need to configure the server. And also we need to configure network. So, operations team also depends on source code management in order to set up networks and also in order to configure servers. In order to set up servers and networks, they will write code and that code is stored in Git. And also QA team, that is nothing but testing team, also use Git. This QA team will store code related to testing in Git. And in order to automatically perform testing, they will use tools like Selenium and JUnit. So even testing team also use Git in order to store code related to testing. And last role is project management. Guys, these project managers will not use source code management like Git softwares because they don't have any idea when compared to technical team. Only technical team will use source code management tools. Guys, for example, if you want to develop any software, then we need to write steps. In olden days, software employees used to create Word documents or they use emails in order to store steps related to develop software. and they used to store that information in Word files or Gmails in order to write complete steps to develop software. But if you store documentation in Word files or Gmails, then it is very hard to find. This wikis tool is example of source code management. Whenever software employees write documentation, they used to store their documents in wiki software. So if you store documents in wiki software, then it is very easy to find those documents. So these are various roles use source code management softwares like Git in order to store their code. So source code management tools are very important for many roles in DevOps. So developers, operations team, testing team depends on source code management tools in order to smoothly complete their work. Project managers don't have any idea about these tools. So even to store documents, people depends on source code management tools like wikis. So if you store all documents related to company in one place, it is very easy to find those documents. So by using different source code management tools, companies can work better.